between Lee and Swinton. Swinton. Referee this afternoon is Robin Whitfield from Widnes, and our two touch judges are Monsieur M. Haig and K. Spencer. And first apology goes to the Swinton hooker Alex Melling, who in fact is the skipper this afternoon, not scrum half Barry Ashall. So these two sides, of course, met in the opening match of the season here at Hilton Park. That, of course, was a first-round tie in the Lancashire Cup, which Lee won by 26 points to 6. This afternoon, it's vital league points on the line for both sides. And it's Swinton in possession from the kick-off, playing from left to right. Maybe there's skipper Alex Melling behind to play the ball. First man in, Tim Strait, stopped by Tony Iroh and Peter Apatity. Ball finds its way out to Andy Purcell. Melling with the dummy from acting halfback. Makes 5 yards before Potter gets the tattle in. Line break from Ashall. Shot players both sides. Great defence though by David Ruane for Lee. Last tattle indicates referee Whitfield, but a bright start by Swinton. Kick coming in from loose forward Sabritsky. Beats Barry Ledger. And we'll have the first scrum of the game over on the far side of the field, inside the home 25. Well, on that 26-6 victory in the first match of the season, Swinton opened with a try inside the first 2 minutes. And they were certainly looking to do the same again on that occasion. But Lee come up with the ball at that scrum. Ruane now tries to take them on, stopped by his opposite number Griffiths. Brian Case now. Good tattling though by Allen. This time Peter Brown, the man driving in. The tattle comes in from Tupai. Paul Topping, ex-Swinton favourite last season of course, puts the kick in. Taken by his opposite number Mellor. Just outside his own 25, and he's stopped 10 yards short of halfway by Mick Dean's tattle. So Swinton just short of halfway with skipper Melling going from acting halfback. He's got Street with him, elects to go it alone. Potter makes the tattle for Lee. Street now at acting halfback, moves it down the short side to Purcell. Lee covers across well. Good crowd here in Hilton Park this afternoon. Swinton moving the ball out well. Sabritsky tries to straighten the move up. Ashall with the kick again. Two fine kicks, one from Sabritsky, one from Ashall. Both found touch inside the home 25. And Lee will have the feed at the second scrum. Both these sides only been beaten once in the league this season, both by the same club. Club being Halifax. Ball's out now to Ledger. Good tattle coming in from Mellor. They move it out now to Rowan, to Rapate. Peter Rapate stopped there by his brother Joel, playing in the centre for Swinton this afternoon. Brown now. Fine break by Brown. Gets it out to Roan. Fine cover tackle from Scott Ranson. A good break down this near side from the lead number 8, Peter Brown. Taking a bit of stick in the press recently for his performances, Peter Brown. Certainly setting the pace on that occasion. This time it's Ashall to feed and possession goes Swinton's way. Cover tackle comes in from Iro. John Allen now. Little to choose between these sides in the opening 5 minutes. Tim Street now. Fine break by Street. Good support coming in from Pusell. Fine play by Swinton. Wayne with the stop for Leap. And now it's Ashall. Tries to use centre at Snape. Lee defence there in numbers on that occasion. So Swinton now with Sabritsky. Fine shot, kick through. Knocked on though by Danny Griffiths. In fact, he's lost possession. Peter Paul Topping comes up with it for Lee. Then Ian Potter knocks on at the play of the ball. And Lee will be forced to scrum it 15 yards in front of their own post. With Eden Ball to Swinton. Barry Ashaw with the feed. Scrum's 2-1 in Lee's favour at the moment. Possession goes Swinton's way again. It's now out to Rapate. Stopped by Jeffrey. Melling behind the play of the ball. Brings in Pusell. Good tattling from Iroll. Melling to Street. Street tries to take on the Lee defence. Jeffrey makes the stop. Griffiths now. Gets it out to Ashall. That's a fine kick indeed. Paul Topping covers it well, but forced to take it over the dead ball line. Good chase from Steve Snape and Logan Edwards over on the far side. Swinton very enterprising in these opening minutes. So it'll be Paul Topping to drop out from under the Lee poles. Kick up to halfway. Take my Scott Ranson. So what can the Swinton leading try scorer do? Makes 15 yards before he falls to an Iro tattle. Melling well wrapped up though by Dean. Ranson now behind the play of the ball. Brings in Allen. Good tattle coming in from Brown. Alex Melling once more. It's time to Street. Charge by Street. Takes play up to the home 25 once more. Swinton looking to make this pressure turn into points. Sabritsky now. Long pass out to Rapate. Brings in fullback Mellor. The wingman had gone inside. Good defence from Round. Last tattle indicates the referee. Kick comes in from Rapate. Lee have that one covered. But the try is given to Logan Edwards. Two Lee men ball watching. Fine judge kick from Joe Rapate. And Logan Edwards opens the scoring for Swinton. After just 7.5 minutes play, it's Lee 0, Swinton 4. So Logan Edwards' sixth try of the season for Swinton puts the visitors in the lead in this final top of the table second division fixture here at Hilton Park. No mistake from scrum half, Barry Ashall with the conversion. 8 minutes of the game gone. A scoreline here at Hilton Park of Lee 0, Swinton 6. So Paul Topping with the restart for Lee. Thane Marsabritsky. He stopped on the 25 and Swinton back in possession once more. Well, Swinton will be happy to have turned that territorial advantage into points. Lee caught offside there. The first penalty of the game was the way of the visitors. And Swinton in command at the moment. So Sabritsky with the kick. Takes play back into the home half. Melling will take the tap. Over on the far side. This man in is Busell. Ashall now brings in Street. Street dodges and weaves. Stopped by Potranairo in the end. But now Ashall on to Griffiths. Short ball to Allen. Melling once more. Here comes Griffiths again. It's it away to Street. Street shrugs off the lead players, gets the ball away in the end. It's now with Allen. Good play from Swinton, keeping the ball alive. Ashall makes the break. Swinton with players over. Great tackle by Iroh, but good play by Ashall for the supporting Griffiths. Swinton looking good. Using the short side to Tupai. He stopped 10 yards out. Positions there now for Swinton. Ashall with the kick again. Taken this time by Ruane. He runs back into trouble. And stopped 15 yards from his own try line. So, what can Lee do with the ball? They've not had much of it in the last 6 or 7 minutes. They need to play with it for a while. Swinton are caught offside this time. Lee get their first penalty of the game. Comes in the 11th minute and they trail Swinton at the moment by 6-0. Well, a kick by Topping, takes play into the Swinton half. Dean with the tap, first man in his case. Tattle him from Swinton. Brown now. Down upended by Sabritsky. Dean now to Ruane. On to Iroh. Iroh stretches the ball. Ball falls for Topping in the end. Backwards said the referee. He keep it moving with the Ruane. On to Beardmore to Rapati. Brilliant tackle by Rapati by Allen. Beardmore now gets it out to Woods. Wood stopped on the 25 by Tupai. Fine up and under from Brown for everyone to chase there. Ball is lost. All on, says the referee. Falls kindly for Swinton in the end. Scott Ransom picks up the pieces for the visitors. So what can Swinton do in reply? That's the best we've seen from Lee. They're still behind. Here comes Pusill again. Another good charge from the number 10. Breaking through the first would-be Lee Tatler. And then Potter forced to concede a penalty round the play of the ball. He knew he was in an offside position, but Alex Melling was on the break. So Swinton. Peter Sabritsky to take the kick for touch. Takes play up to halfway. Well, Lee didn't know they had a match on their hands beforehand. They certainly do now. Straight runs into Casey's tattle. And now on to Ashall. Pym Street laid out down in front of us. Play goes on though with the centre Snape. Swinton moving it now with Tupai. Here comes Ashall. Fine break by Griffiths, and it's Swinton with a great chance again. Ball's thrown away. Swinton pick up the pieces, but the referee calls them back for a knock-on. And Tim Street in some distress down on the halfway line. Swinton will be forced to back down with five players in this scrum. Beardmore to feed. Lee come up with possession. Back to Ruane. Great tackling from Tupai. Rapata now taking them on. Stopped by Pusil, just short of the 25. Brown only gets a couple of yards. Beardmore takes them on in centre field. Makes 10 yards. Lee looking for the kick from Brown this time. Forces Edwards to turn and chase. Edwards picks it up inside his own 25. Tattle comes in from Potter in the end. Well, fullback Mellor going from acting halfback. Snape in on the action. Malling now, out to Ashall. On to Sabritsky, who gets a good ball out to Griffiths. Defence by Lee in the end. Swinton looking quite good with the ball in their hands. Malling again to Ashall, who puts in the kick again. Well picked off by Beardmore. He stopped short of halfway by Allen. And Nashall. Potter makes 5 yards, takes play over halfway. Case is wrapped up, and Swinton certainly giving nothing away in centre field at the moment. Beardmore now, Turrowane, onto Irol. Irol puts Topping through the gap, but Topping couldn't take the pass. Tim Street in a bad way, forced to leave the field of play. The ironical cheers this time, of course, from the Lee supporters. Street was a favourite with them last season. Well, Ian Pickavance has come on to go on the left wing, and Logan Edwards, the try scorer, has moved into the pack. So it's Asher Hall to feed the scrum for Swinton. Possession to Swinton once more. Ball's loose, picked up by Ashall again. Stopped by Woods and Rapata, just short of halfway. Mellor brings in Tupai. Tattle from Ruane. Pusil now. Comes John Allen. Ball is loosed. The referee says it went backwards. Ashall regains possession for Swinton. Judging and weaving again from half back by Skipper Melling. Sabritsky looked as though he was going to kick in the end, passed it. A poor kick from Scott Ramson goes actually backwards. And then another kick in the end finds its way to Ledger. Ledger can't get through Pickavance's tattle though. In fact, Swinton come up with the ball. It's now on to Tupai. And Barry Ledger down injured for Lee. So here comes John Allen. And Swinton beginning to get on top once more. Pusil. Tattling from Case and Irol. Melling now to Griffiths. Bring in Rapata. Good tattle though by Jeffrey. Scott Ransom now. Sit out to Ashall. Fullback Mellor. He's well wrapped up though by McAdeen. Melling to Ashall again, on to Sabritsky, long ball out to Ransom, takes them on in the end, a great tackle. In fact, the ball is lost and it's a turnover anyway, the first one of the game going the way of Lee. So what can Lee do? Lee have got to get themselves back into this game. Round well wrapped up by Ransom. Dean going it alone from acting half back. Well, Edge is still out of the game receiving treatment. Wayne goes back into trouble. The fans not happy with this performance at the moment. Brown forced to kick. An easy one for Pickavance to take. Just outside his own 25. Lear there in numbers. Going to make the first time tattling count more. Melling again tries to catch them out from acting half back. And it's Barry Ashall going from acting half back, and Leah wide open once more. Ashall going through them as though they're not there. Tattle comes in from Beardmore in the end, but Ashall went through six would-be lead tattlers there. Snape now. And Snape still going, he stopped 15 yards out. So what can Swinton do with this good attacking position? Sabritsky now. Inside ball to Repartee. Mick Dean gets a hand to that one. Couldn't hold on. Certainly a try-saving knockdown by Mick Dean. But they'll scrum it right in front of the lead post and head and ball to the visitors. Swinton keep the pressure on. Once again looking to make the possession count with points. Ashall comes up with the ball again from the scrum. Griffiths on the run around with Snape. So Pickavance now attacking halfback. He makes 5 yards before he's upended by Woods. Pusil on the charge. Just a couple of yards short. Swinton threaten again. Good line out this way. It's out to Repartee, and Repartee gets over. No problems for Swinton. 21 minutes gone. Chance of easy from the Swinton supporters. And few would argue with them at this point in time. Because really there's only been one side in it in this first 20 minutes. Joe Repartee gets Swinton's second try of the game to put them ahead by 10 points to nil. And that brings an immediate reaction from the Lee bench as both Lee substitutes loosen up. Ashall with his second attempt of the afternoon from just to the right of the lead pulse. Makes no mistake once again. 22 minutes of this first half gone in this Stonesbitty Championship second division fixture here at Hilton Park, and it's a poor scoreline as far as the home supporters are concerned, because it now reads Lee 0, Swinton 12. So Topping with the restart. Ball beats Pickavance, but not Edwards. Well, that will certainly encourage Swinton to better things, one would have thought. In full cry at the moment. And we have certainly got to tattle up on their first time tattling. So here comes Sabritsky. Stopped by his opposite number, Peter Repartee. Kick comes in from fullback Mellor. They get a penalty in the end for not giving Topping the requisite 10 yards. Barry Ledger appears to be holding his arm on the far side. So they've got all sorts of problems. It's Casey's first man in, stopped by Allen. Brown now. Good defence again by Swinton. Ruane going the other way now. Onto Rapati. He can't get away from Pickavance. Swinton force him out of play. Good play from Swinton once more. They're really dominating at the moment. Lee want to bring Tony Cottrell on. And Barry Ledger is the man to go off. Well, Ledger looked in some discomfort. Jeffrey will go on to the right wing. Iro to the centre. And Tony Cottrell will go into the pack. Oh, that's another bad blow for Lee. Swinton come up with possession from the scrum. So here comes Griffiths, going from acting half-back. Handful tap by Jeffrey. Barty completes the tackle, but once again, Swinton just running through this paper-thin Lee defence. There's yet another break. Round intercepts for Lee, that's a bit of relief. Tries the counter, but again, solid tackling from Melling and Allen. Well, Lee go the wrong way, but Potter on the charge, takes play back into the Swinton half. Woods now out to Beardmore. The crowd tried to get behind Lee. Ruane looks for the gap. That's it inside to Jeffrey. On to Topping. Topping stopped. 15 yards out. This is Lee's best attack of the game. And a good line out here. Inside to Beardmore. Lee keep the pressure on, but Swinton defence is holding at the moment. Wide pass out to Brown. And in the end, Lee get the penalty. Peter Brown wanted to play the ball quickly. He will get six more. Brown plays it to himself. Takes them on. Manages to stay in play. They really need points from this situation. Dean now to Case. Swinton up quickly. Lee had a good line out but didn't run it. Dean now to Beardmore, on to Potter, Cottrell gets it on to Topping, and Paul Topping opens Lee's account. It's taken Lee 27 minutes to get on the score sheet. In the end it was substitute Tony Cottrell who made the initial break. Paul Topping was the man supporting the move. Topping opens Lee's scoring with their first try of the game. It's now Lee 4 points, Swinton 12. That's something for the Lee supporters to cheer about. Paul Topping with the opportunity to reduce the arrears to 6 points. His first attempt of the game. Just to the right of the Swinton pulse. It over off the post. Oh, could that be Lee's luck changing? 12 minutes of the first half remain in this second division fixture here at Hilton Park. The scoreline now of Lee 6 points, Swinton 12. So Swinton back at the centre with the restart. Jeffrey knocks on, and we'll scrum it 10 yards from the Lee try line. And Lee put themselves immediately back under pressure. And Swinton will look to regain those 6 points that they've just conceded. Come up with the ball once more. Here goes Snape now. It's better defence from Lee. Fine ball, finding Sobritski in the centre position. Lee defence holds on that occasion. Welling tries his luck from acting half-back. He read that one this time. Sabritsky on to Purcell. Cottrell in on this stop. Jorabadi moved out deep to the left-hand side. Tapayi out. He's held 5 yards out, and it's the last tattle, indicates the referee. Melling now. Tries to use the short ball. Sabritsky puts in the eye kick in the end. Ball is fumbled by Rapati, and Lee scramble it over the dead ball line. Swinton keep the pressure on. Lee forced to drop out from under their own posts. So ball topping with a high drop kick taken by Meller. McTuttle coming in from Dean. From John Allen on the drive. Now it's Melling behind the play of the ball. Brings in Tupai. Tupai shrugs them off again, gets it away to Oshall. And the Lee defence taken apart once more. Here comes Snape now. Drop goal comes in from Ashall. Swinton elect to have a cushion to play with. A 1 point from Ashall gives them a 7 point advantage. Scoreline now reads Lee 6 points, Swinton 13, and we've got 9 minutes of the half remaining. So topping with the restart. Well taken by Mallet. Makes 35 yards before he stopped. Cases the tattler for Lee. Here comes Purcell. Sabritsky now. Gets the ball round the man well to Rabate. Swinton really putting the ball to good use in this first half. Griffiths now, dummies. Lee don't take it. Last one indicates the referee. Sabritsky with the kick. Jeffrey takes that one well. It's away from two tattlers. Stopped by Pickavance in the end. Lee in possession once more, just outside their own 25. With topping. Pickavance with the tattle again. Lee slow to regroup. Dean now to Baden. On to Rapati. Rapati runs straight into Allen's tattle though. Dean now to Case. On to Brown. Brown looking to unleash the ball in the tattle, but can't escape the clutches of Sabritsky. Beardmore now. Tried to use the short ball with Iroh, but again, good defence by Ashall. And topping gets wrapped up on the sixth tackle. The ball, Lee gets the ball away somehow. Kick comes in from Ruane. Pickavance gets it at the second attempt. Runs into Woods though. So here comes Purcell once more for Swinton. John Allen this time. Now with Snape. Again, poor tattling by Lee. The man in support is Ashall. The kick ahead. Where's the paceman? The kick is too long. But it was a good break again from Swinton. really tearing the heart out of this Lee defence. Beardmore on to Potter. Lee were too slow to get things moving. Dean now down the short side, inside to Brown. Swinton will stand that all afternoon. It's too pedestrian from Lee at the moment. Beardmore. Ball's knocked down, but it could break the Lee with the way. Gets it on to Rapati. Has Rapati got the legs? Good cover though from Swinton. Rapati was looking for a speedman by his side. Rowane's down injured for Lee. Now out with Irol. Gets it away to Mick Round. But Round goes without the ball. Touch judge on the far side is on. Another chance goes begging for Lee. We'll have to see. He had passed it out to Peter Rapati. Wayne limps back into the action and the referee will take them all the way back for the penalty to Lee. Well, he brings play back some 30 yards to where the incident occurred. The penalty goes Lee's way. And who is the man to be called out? It's fullback Paul Mellott. So Paul Topping with the kick for Lee. So from Swinton having a head and ball at the scrum, Lee now have six tackles inside the Swinton 25, and they really need points before half time. Got just four, we're inside the last 4 minutes. Lee with the attacking position. Beardmore now, bring in Brown. Ball is lost, but Lee regather. Beardmore now. Out to Ruane, inside to Rapati. Gets it away to Case. Case gets it inside to Ruane. Good defence again from Swinton, but this is a good position for Lee. They've got to make something out of it. Brown now. Terrible ball. Jeffrey recovers the position though. Lee still have possession. Terrible pass though, but Dean puts in a kick. Taken by Mellor over his own try line, and Swinton will tap from their own 25. Well, that was better from Lee, but they really needed points from that situation. Full credit to the visitors for their defence. Now Shane Tapai is the first man driving him. Here comes Busell. John Allen now. Brown and Potter with the stop for Lee. Kick will come in from Mellott. Ball bounces unkindly for Jeffrey. Picks it up on his own try line in the end. Does well to stay in play in the end. Topping now, gets it out to Ruane. Ruane stopped short of the 25. Case now. Dean on to Rapati. Rapati clears the 25 before he stopped. Forced to go out alone in the end. Last one indicates the referee. Woods behind the play of the ball. Gets it out to Topping. Gets the kick in. Pick advance and take that one easily. Good tattle though from Jeffrey. And Swinton will certainly be happy with this scoreline at half time. And they've got a minute of the half remaining. And Shane Tapia is stopped by Brown. Good tattle by Cottrell on Pusil. Now with Sabritsky, the kick ahead. Well taken by Irol. Irol stopped just outside the 25. Six more tattles for Lee, indicates the referee. Cottrell with the charge. Can Lee get anything before the interval? Only 20 seconds of normal time remaining. Beardmore now out to Rowain. Rowain goes back into trouble though. Now Cottrell's limping on the far side. Beardmore now. Brown, but no centre there. Dean gets it out to Brown. He puts the kick in. Bounces kindly for Swinton. Paul Mellor will take that one. 15 yards from his own try line. Gets it away to the supporting Ransom. Swinton back in possession, just outside their own 25. Pusel now. Melling behind the play of the ball. Ringing Allen. It's now with Snape. Out to Pickavant. The defence again by Jeffrey on the far side. Swinton just short of halfway. Snape with the kick this time. Topping gets that one. Topping looking for the space down centre field. Stopped 10 yards short of halfway. Irol gets that one away to Woods. Woods rounds his man. John Woods on the break. Good cover from Swinton. As the Hooter goes to bring to an end. First half. Results in derisions of boos from the home supporters to half-time scoreline here at Hilton Park of Lee 6 points, Swinton 13.
I'm not great, I know.
Well, welcome back to Hilton Park, Lee. Well, this afternoon, Storm's bit of Championship second division fixture. We've been entertained during the half-time interval by a reunion of the 1971 Lee Rugby League Cup final winning team. But we've had an half-time interval of in excess of 30 minutes due to a power failure. We hope the floodlights are on now to stay. A reminder of the half-time scoreline in this top-of-the-table second division fixture. It's Lee 6 points, Swinton 13. Doesn't appear to have been any substitutions during the half-time. Both sides will be looking to get warmed up pretty quickly for this second period. Swinton's first half tries coming from Logan Edwards and Joe Rapati, with both converted by Barry Ashall, who added a drop goal. Paul Topping with the try and the conversion for the home side. So referee Robin Whitfield out to get the game underway again. And it's Danny Griffiths with the restart. And Lee get possession with John Woods from the kickoff. So what will this second half hold for both these promotion contenders? Here comes Rapati driving in for Lee. Defence is there again for Swinton. Second row pair of Shane Tupai and John Allen. Woods. Quite is Paul Topping with the kick eventually, and a fine kick it is. Mellor takes it just 20 yards from his own try line. Wayne Monaro make the stop between them. Here comes Scott Ransom, forced across field because Swinton very slow getting back on this occasion. Here comes Pusil though. He's had a good first half and started off as he finished at the end of the first period, driving in strongly. Kick comes in from Sabritsky. Jeffrey takes it for Lee. Pick advance with the tackle for Swinton. So Lee, 35 yards out, their first real attack of this second period. Ryan Case runs into Sabritsky's tackle. Dean now, onto Rapati. Rapati stopped by Edwards. Beardmore now, out to Rowain. Defence holds once more. Brown. No way past Tupai though. Last one indicates the referee. Beardmore launches the high upper number. Mellor takes it just short of the try line. Rowain makes the tackle. What can Lee do defensively? He's got to keep Swinton down here. Scott Ransom on the reply from acting halfback. Stopped 15 yards from his own try line. Using the short side with Pusil once more. finally gets to Tatlin on the 25. And it's Allen driving in. Swinter with a good line out here. Good tackle by Beardmore though, on Griffiths. Kick will come in from Ashall. It's a bad one. And he will get the advantage of the turnover in the second of the game. So Lee keep the pressure on their opponents, looking to drag themselves back into this game. Got to score twice, of course, to win it. Dino to Rapati and to Potter. Good defence again from Tupai. Tupai in on the stop again. But Lee keep the ball moving. Dean up to the 25 with some risk of making the tackle. Beardmore now. Goes back inside. Top 20 yards out. Brown takes it to within 10 yards of those with Swinton Pulse. Lee with a good line out here now. Rain comes back inside, gets it into Potter. Lee go backwards. It's the last tackle, indicates the referee. Beardmore with the searching kick, but it's too long. Shepherded over the dead ball line by substitute Pickavance. The chance is lost. And Swinton get possession back with a 25-yard tap. This one in again is Puso. Milling on to Allen. Swinton yet to get in this game in this second period. Had just 5 minutes of the second half, but Swinton still lead by 13 points to 6. Comes to Pai. And in the end, Brian Case is penalised. It's the first penalty of this second half. First half penalties were 4-2 in Lee's favour, scrum 6-3 in Swinton's favour. 3 wanting to get the game underway, and Peter Sobretzky with the kick for touch. And down receiving treatment, I think, is Shane Tupai. So Melling with the top, 5 yards inside the Lee half. This one in again is Puso. What a great charge, and a great ball on to Ramson. Brilliant defence though by Topping, but superb attack from Swinton. Swinton looking to wrap this game up here. Rapati with no one outside him, but he's got players inside him. There's Ashall. Lee's defence being put to the test once more. There goes Pusil. Stopped about 5 yards out. Free taking the lead. Defenders back to their own try line. Looking for a work move here. Chance is lost. Lee come up with possession. And the Swinton player down injured. So the referee stops the clock to play the ball.
Come on, Lee!
Brown makes about 5 yards as Lee loosen up Mark Shields. Touch judges on the far side now. And the penalty goal Swinton's way. In a very kickable position. So a bit of indiscipline by someone on the Lee side there, spotted by the touch judge on the far side as Lee want to make a substitution.
Come on,
Mark Shields coming on to replace Ian Potter. Mark Shields, of course, a former Swindon player of last season. So 8 minutes of the second half gone. Maria Scholl's third attempt of the game. It's wide with that one. A lead for the home side. The score remains the same. Lee 6, Swindon 13. And Lee to drop out from their own 25. And topping with the drop kick. All the way to the Swindon 25, where it's picked up by Mellor. Woods and Beardmore make the stop. So what can Swindon do now? Pick of Ants behind the play of the ball. Goes from acting half-back. Shields quickly in on the action. On to Melling. Good tattle by Cottrell on Allen. Certainly didn't appear to be high from where I'm standing. The referee tells John Allen to get up and get on with it. No, does that constitute a professional foul? But no. Zabritsky stopped by Shields and Cottrell. Pardon, Shields and Case. And here comes Snape. Bring full back. And Mellor into the line. Lee stop him on the home 25, but he loses possession and Lee come up with the ball. So what can Lee do now? They're 10 yards outside their own 25. Bring in Iroh. He gets round away. Owen tries to step inside the defence. He's just held. Beardmore gets away well. Woods couldn't quite get the ball out in the tattle there. Peter Brown now out to Jeffrey. Jeffrey forced back inside, stopped by Allen and Zabritsky. Last one indicates the referee. Brown now to Beardmore, onto Ruane. Long ball finds Irel. Inside to Brown, and it's going to be a turnover going the way of the visitors. Certainly giving it a goal. They've got to do that. So what can Swindon do in reply? They're in possession midway between halfway and their own 25. Over on the far side, here comes Pusel again. And again he's proven a handful for the Lee tattlers. Six more tattles indicates the referee. McDean touching the ball with his foot at the play of the ball. Good tattle again, this time from Cottrell. Zabritsky now brings into Pye. It's better defence from Lee. Milling now to Zabritsky. Well, that looked higher than the last one, but Lee get away with it. John Allen was the man this time. Lee tattling, adding a bit of venom to the game. Zabritsky's long ball out. Kick should find Jeffrey. Jeffrey now. Runs into Snape and Pick of Ants though. And Lee are back in possession 10 yards short of halfway. Shields now. Shields takes it up to halfway. Beardmore now to Ruane. On to Woods. Woods trying to fox his way through centre field. Lee certainly looking better at the moment. Dean gets away to Beardmore, onto Rapati. Good defending again by Swindon. Brown now. Beardmore. Turnover, the ball was put on the ground. John Woods played it back for Lee and was penalised. The referee scratches his head, as do a lot of Lee supporters. Very happy. happy with that decision by referee Robin Whitfield. Phil Swinton electing to run it with Pusil. Ball is lost in the tackle. Shields quickly in with the stop as Smelling picks up the pieces for Swinton. Ashall now on to Allen. Well, they have got to find points from somewhere and quickly to get back in this game. Well, Topping comes up with that ball from that kick. Missed away well to Brown. Lee in possession on their own 25. The party now. Good defence again from Swinton. Tattler this time is to Pye. In case, doesn't gain any yardage out of that run. Beardmore now on to Cottrell. Cottrell gets away well to Case. And a good tackle from Sobretzky. Lee looking for more room than Swinton will give them at the moment. Beardmore now. Woods couldn't take the pass. Referee will call the mat for the knock on in centre field. You just need them to calm it down a little. Try and play their rugby. Head and ball to Swinton. 14 and a half minutes of this second half gone. Lee still trail by 13 points to 6. Swinton come up with possession from the first scrum of the half. Party makes the stop. Snape plays it to himself. Held up by Topping, another try saving tackle by Topping, and he comes up with the ball as well. So relief for the home side once more. Swinton not giving Lee any space again. Swinton moving up very quickly on this Lee attack. Dean getting 5 yards out of that move. The last tackle and Lee are still inside their own 25. Ruane with the kick. Drives them back, but it's an easy one for Ranson to take. Put the pressure back on Lee. It's away from Round's tackle and eye rolls. Ruane recovers to make the stop. Swinton back in possession in Lee territory. Good tackle on John Allen. Hill now on the drive. Melling moves it out to Ashall, to Sobretzky, to Snape. On to Edwards, inside to Pickabout. He loses the ball. Beardmore comes up with it for Lee. Case now out to Woods, to Shields. Shields tries to scatter them in centre field, loses the ball in a three-man tattle. Topaya picks it up for Swinton, steps inside the first tattler. Topping makes the stop again for Lee. So Sobretzky now for Swinton. Out to Snape, short ball to Edwards. This runs into a tattle from Cottrell. Snape moves it inside now to Allen. Cottrell in well again for Lee. Melling reversing the roles now. It's now with Sobretzky. Swinton with a big overlap here. And he gets away from Topping. Lee holds him up on the line. And he gets the pass out, but still the Lee defence holds. Well, Swinton can wrap it up with 6 points here. Ball is lost though. Lee come up with possession, and it's a turnover anyway. It's Lee's third turnover of the game. Swinton have got Lee in a stranglehold at the moment. Referee has called them back for the knock-on. Shane Topaya was over the Lee try line. Set and ball to Swinton. Swinton can feel aggrieved at that decision. Possession to Swinton now. What can they do inside the Lee 25? Ball is dropped. All on, says the referee. Snape inside to Ransom. Bounces off Tattlers. Gets it away to Mellor. Lee forced to defend once more. Swinton using the short side with Allen again. This is a good spell for Swinton, but they really need points from it. Snape gets away from two Tattles. Now here comes Sobritski looking for a set move, which almost works. Good defence in the end by Lee. Last tackle indicates the referee. The drop goal comes from scrum half Barry Ashall again. There's two drop goals, stretches the Swinton lead to 8 points. We've had 19 minutes of this second half, and the scoreline here at Hilton Park now reads Lee 6 points, Swinton 14. So Topping with the restart. Taken by Mellor again. Swinton playing with total confidence at the moment. Mellor loses scrum cap in that tattle with Cottrell. Cusel bounces off Cottrell, gets the ball away. Woods with the stop for Lee.
Come on, Jeff, he's your way to stop.
Welcome to Pye again, an overlap here for Swinton. An interception by Ruane. Gets it on to the supporting Topping. Topping changes the direction of the attack. Goes back inside, stopped by Pickavance. Case now for Lee, onto Rapati. Rapati makes a storming run down centre field. Dean gets it away to Beardmore. Onto Iroh. Iroh gets it away to Case. Case stops short of the 25. Comes now to Brown. Brown stopped on the 25. Good tattle coming in again from Tapai. Beardmore gets it on to Case. He throws it away to Cottrell. Cottrell forced back inside, gets it away in the scrum, in the tattle. To Ruane now. On to Woods. Is it Iroh? Couldn't take the ball though. Chance is lost again. Certainly better play from Lee. Shuffled their backs around. David Ruane has gone into the centre. Woods to half back. The Swinton line leading a charmed life at the moment. Lee have had the opportunities. Swinton get possession from the scrum. Lee have got to keep them in this 25 area if at all possible. Melling now, on to Pusel again. Another good charge from the number 10. Ashall gets it away to the fullback. Mellor. He's wrapped up though by Cottrell. Cottrell not happy with Griffiths in that tackle. Ashall with the kick. Jeffrey juddles with it before taking it. Gets it away to Topping. Topping outnumbered. Takes them on. Stopped at halfway. Case now. Is it to Dean? To Iroh now. Iroh tries to scatter them, but Sobritski will have none. Swinton tattling as well as ever. They know this game's there for the taking. Beardmore now. On to Brown. Lee 5 yards inside Swinton territory. Clarty going from acting half back. Good defence again by Sobritsky. Woods now. Ruane comes back inside. Is it to the support in Shields? Good break by Shields. Looking for the support. Couldn't find any. Stop 15 yards out. Last tackle indicates the referee. And Lee get a penalty in the end. The first penalty of this second half. It's taken 23 and a half minutes of this second half. And I suppose Paul Topping has no option really but to go for 2 points. Minutes of the game remaining. Lee 8 points behind at the moment. This could take them within a try and a goal if Topping could put it over. So Topping's first attempt went in off the post. The second one fails. Swinton will drop out from their own 25. So Lee really need a try from somewhere at the moment. Swinton in no hurry to get on with things. The Griffiths in the end with the drop out. And Peter Brown takes that one from the kickoff. And Lee are back in possession midway between halfway and the Swinton 25. Shields now. Good drive from Shields. Good tackle from Tapai. Dean now, a terrible ball taken by Rapati. Three-man tackle stops him again. Tapai is in on the stop once more. Beardmore out to Woods. Woods gets it on to Topping. Inside to Jeffrey. Good tackle again by Tapai. Ruane. Beardmore inside to Shields. To Rapati. Rapati taking them on. Good tackle this time. Coming in from Logan Edwards. Lee with a good line out here. Woods now. Woods dodges and weaves, gets it away to Round. Round's forced out, 10 yards short. It's better from Lee, and a good spell at the moment, keeping Swinton in their own territory. 14 minutes remaining at Hilton Park. Swinton still lead by 14 points to 6. In fact, it's a turnover. Swinton's third turnover of this second half. Lee have had three during the game. Swinton 10 yards from their own try line. Everything to play for. Two vital league points at stake. Both sides having lost one game in the league prior to today. And it's a break by Ashall. An ample tap from Cottrell. Stops the move. Ruane completes the stop. Here comes fullback Ranson on to Snape. Half stopped by Cottrell. Jeffrey makes the tackle in the end. Mellor attacked in halfback now for Swinton. Griffiths gets it out to Sobritsky. Tattling by Beardmore. In fact, Beardmore's come up with the ball as well for Lee. A fine break from Woods. He's got it all the way. He's still going. Stopped on the 25 by Mellor. Only looking for the inspiration from someone. Shields takes it another 5 yards near that Swinton try line. Well, if Lee could get a try here, we'd be in for a grandstand finish. But were they going to unlock this Swinton defence? Beardmore. Great defence again on Brown. In fact, it's not Brown. But Lee have got a penalty, I think. Lee electing to run it. Jeffrey forced back inside. Sidesteps and weaves, stopped 15 yards out. Lee gave up the opportunity of 2 points then, so they've got to get something from this drive. Case goes back inside. Ball is lost, went backwards, indicates the referee. Brown drops on it for Lee. Dean now. On to Shields. Shields turns into his former colleagues, driving towards those Swinton poles. Position is there now for Lee. Lee go backwards. Lee got it away well. Woods now. Woods couldn't find Jeffrey. Hiro now. Inside to Case. Snow with Ruain. Ruain gets it away well to Hiro. And Hiro loses the ball, I think. Swinton come up with possession once more. So good defence from Swinton again.
Get rid of that, Murphy!
Scott Ransom trying to break clear for Swinton. Swinton have defended really well under this Lee onslaught. Lee have got to find a try from somewhere, and quickly as well. It's 10.5 minutes remaining here at Elton Park. Lee have got to score twice to win this one. Now Melling behind the play of the ball. On to Ashall, to Sobritsky. It's a long ball out. Read well by Iro. Couldn't get to the ball, but made the tackle on the 25. And Sobritsky puts in the kick. Topping picks it up 10 yards inside his own half. That's away from Edwards. Still going. Gets it out to Jeffrey. Great cover tackle all by John Allen. Topping's down injured. Ruain tries down the short side, throws out a wild ball, picked up by Jeffrey. Lee now with a big overlap here. Ball is knocked down. Cottrell appeared to be obstructed. The chance is lost again. The Swinton defence is being put to the test, and it's holding up to now. So Beardmore to feed. Lee win their first scrum of this second half. Woods tries to take them on. Stop 20 yards out. Now where's the break going to come from for Lee? Ruain onto Rapati. Jeffrey now to Ruain. Ruain on to Dean. To Case. They're just 6-7 yards short again. Shields forced backwards by this terrier tackling of the Swinton defence. Brown 5 yards out, last tackle again. And Ruain is stopped a yard short, and Lee concede another turnover. Full credit to this Swinton defence. Lee has run them ragged, but the defence has held good. And Swinton in no rush to get on with things. Melling makes 5 yards. Swinton will be happy with that. Lee have just got to keep them there. Force an error or force the kick. Here comes Snape. Good tackling by Rapati. Griffiths dodging and weaves. Gets it away to Pickavance. Cottrell gets the tackle in. Swinton have managed to clear the 25.
Come on,
here comes Pusel again. Gets it into the supporting Ashall. Good cover tackle from Woods, but certainly Swinton showing they're not finished yet. Kick comes in from Melling. So Round takes that one for Lee. Lee tries to break clear but can't. Cottrell receiving treatment now for Lee. Stopping trying his luck this time. Lee are still to unlock this Swinton defence in the second half. Shields tries to scatter Ashall but can't. Gawain looking for the gap. Throws a wild ball away in the end. Dean comes up with it for Lee. Now Rapati. Rapati. Out to Brown. Last one again indicates the referee. Rapati with the kick this time. And a good one. Finding touch. This game drifting away from Lee now. 6 minutes remaining. They've thrown everything at Swinton in this second period and they've nothing to show for it. Swinton 8 points clear. They have had the opportunities but not taken them. Swinton win the scrum again. Pick of Ants on the break. This runs Lee ragged. There's three Lee players after him. He's looking for support and got none. And he's stopped on the 25 by Tupping in the end. But Griffiths breaks away from the action halfback. And it's over. Danny Griffiths' try will settle everything. Swinton will take home the league points. We have had all the territorial advantage in the last 20 minutes. They've done everything but score. Swinton have withstood the onslaught and have come back in the best way possible. Danny Griffiths getting their third try of the game. And victory goes the way of Swinton, no doubt about that. 5 minutes remaining at Hilton Park, but Swinton home and dry. They now lead by 18 points to 6, and Nashall with the conversion to follow. Mistake this time from Ashall. Scoreline here at Hilton Park. Lee 6 points, Swinton 20. Just over 4 minutes remaining. Woods with the restart for Lee. And Swinton in possession with Ramson. Can Swinton finish with a flourish? Here comes Tupai. He's had a barnstorming game. Drops the ball. Referee will call them back for the scrum. So Beardmore to feed for Lee. They come up with possession. Woods. Brought down by Mellor's tackle. Case on the drive. Brown now for Lee, takes it into the Swinton 25. Rapati, stopped by Allen's tackle. Cottrell tries to unlock them, no one with him. Last tackle coming up indicates the referee. Short kick ahead. And Beardmore gets the luck of the bounce. Bob Beardmore gets a bit of respite for Lee, but it's come all too late. Beardmore gets Lee's second try of the game. So Paul Tupping with the conversion. gets his second goal of the afternoon, but it's all academic really. 2 minutes remain here at Elton Park. Scoreline now of Lee 12 points, Swinton 20. So Danny Griffiths with the restart once more for Swinton. Jeffrey collects that just inside his own 25. And surely Lee have got to swing it about. And nothing to lose now. Brown just charges into Tupai's tattle. And Shields tries to scatter them. Gets it away well. Lee on the move again. Party forced back inside by Ransom. Shields takes it on, gets the ball away in the tattle. Woods now. Woods trying to ghost his way through, gets it away well to Dean. Dean now takes it inside. Dean still going. Stopped just 20 yards out. Last one indicates the referee. Beardmore, no, it's now with Cottrell. Cottrell puts in the kick. What's the referee give him? A dropout under the pulse. So we move into added time now at the end of this second division fixture here at Elton Park. Peter Rapart has been adjudged the Lee man of the match, but it's Peter Sobritsky with the dropout for Swinton. So Paul Topping now. The hooter goal to put Lee supporters out of their misery. A final scoreline here at Elton Park of Lee 12 points, Swinton 20. Tries for Lee by Paul Topping and Bob Beardmore, both converted by Topping. For Swinton, a try each for Logan Edwards, Joe Rapati and Danny Griffiths, with Barry Ashall converting all three and adding two drop goals. So it's goodbye from Hilton Park with a final reminder of this afternoon's scoreline in the Stones Bitter Championship second division fixture. It's Lee 12 points, Swinton 20.
David Mail never knows what that was. Stapleton heads it through to Gale. Reid Sellers does well to bring that under control and find John Miller. Ali Dawson looking to swing one in, but it ends in disappointment. Clive Baker clears it upfield looking for O'Connell. It'll be Barnsley, throw to Barnsley as they look to claim the spoils. Yeah. Moran with a powerful header out. Simon Garner looking for John Miller, but Agnew was in once again. O'Connell for Fleming. An awful cross. Brings Rovers relief. Looks increasingly like the game will finish with a goalless draw unless something extraordinary happens the next minute or so. Agnew brought down by a combination of Sellers and Miller. Don McCarr decides to make another substitution. Alan Irving will come on for Simon Garner. Substitution in the 90th minute. Alan Irving had his scoring boots on Saturday, but will he have time tonight? Fluff clearance by Terry Jenner. Kevin Moran spurs his blushes. Kevin Moran's first touch wasn't the most sure. It takes a lot to ruffle the big Irishman. Sellers. Kevin Dawson. We've got time to swing one last cross in. It's for John Miller. Nicky Reid, Irvin. Throw into Rovers. Irvin over Ballantyne. Atkins inside for Howard Gale. Mark Atkins once more. Plays a perfect ball to a Barnsley defender. Dawson looking for Scott Sellers. Sellers gets ahead on it. And Boys are looking for one final foray forward. Barnsley looking to make a second substitution, even 2 minutes into injury time. Well, Robinson will take the fray. Place of Fleming. It's a free kick for Barnsley. Agnew pumps the ball into the Rovers area. Geno punches. Cancelo's come away. He's got Irving outside him. Fresh pair of legs. In keeping with much of the play in the second half, the cross is pretty dismal. Mr. Wright decides that's quite enough, and we have, after 90 minutes, a pretty disappointing ending scoreline for both teams. Barnsley 0, Blackburn Rovers 0.